Tesla Model Y is on track to become the world's best-selling car. Maria Merano reports from Tesla Radio, and based on today's reports from Tesla, that Elon Musk projected that the Tesla Model Y could become the world's best-selling car by 2022 or 2023. In a little bit later, I'm going to tell you why I think Tesla is working on a drastic price reduction of Model Y. But for now, Musk announced that the Tesla Model 3 became the best-selling luxury sedan of any kind in the world during its latest earnings call. Based on Tesla's calculations, the Model Y could beat the Model 3's record. I'd say more likely than not that in 2022, Model Y is the best-selling car or truck of any kind in the world, said Elon Musk during the Q1 2021 earnings call. Dave Lee said, if you missed Tesla's earnings, the highlight was Elon Musk sharing in the call that he thinks Tesla's Model Y will become the top-selling vehicle of any kind in 2022 and 2023. World's top-selling car currently is Toyota Corolla at 1.5 million units per year. This means that if Tesla wants to make the Model Y the top-selling car in the world the next year or in 2023, this means Tesla needs to sell at least 1.5 million Tesla Model Ys to exceed Toyota Corolla. And to this, Elon Musk responded saying, seems quite likely, at least based on revenue in 2022 and possibly total units in 2023. But in a moment, I will tell you why I think that Tesla may be working on drastic price cuts on Model Y, and I'm going to ask you if that's true, how Tesla can do this. Now, after the call, Musk reiterated his projection on Twitter, like I said, responding to longtime investor Dave Lee, who pointed out the amount of Model Y vehicle would need to produce and deliver to become the world's top-selling vehicle. Seems quite likely, at least based on revenue in 2022 and possibly total units in 2023, Musk said. Last year, Ford sold the most vehicles thanks to its F-Series, reported Forbes. The legacy automaker sold 787,422 total vehicles in 2020, a notable accomplishment considering this virus. In terms of the F-Series, Ford experienced a minus 12.2% change in F-Series sales, revealing the impact of this virus. A year before this virus, in 2019, the top-selling car in the world was the Toyota Corolla, with over 1.2 million models sold that year, calculated Statista. You know, Model Y production rate in Shanghai continues to improve quickly, and two new factories, Berlin and Texas, are making progress, wrote Tesla in its update letter for Q1 2021. Now to the price reduction. Here's the thing. This is kind of insane, right? That Tesla will make 1.5 million Model Ys at least to top the Toyota Corolla. I mean, imagine, a $60,000 car isn't going to outsell the Accord unless there are even more massive redistribution efforts to ease the burden, particularly in this great kind of reset economy, right? Say, like writes Todd Gobbler in Tesla Radio's comment section. But to this, another commenter, Roy, says, this is exactly why I believe Tesla is working on a drastic price reduction. As outlined in Battery Day, cost will come down about 50%. There is also cost reduction from aluminum cast frames, stiffer wiring harnesses that will be easier for robots to install. 48V instead of 12V reduces required wire size, and who knows what else they have up in their sleeves. So it's very likely that Tesla is working on price reduction and reduction on Model Y. The Model Y price probably will come down significantly by end of 2022 and early 2023, and this Tesla will have a great shot at making Model Y the world's top-selling electric vehicle, or world's top-selling vehicle. So what are your thoughts on this, friends? Do you think Tesla can do this, and in what ways do you think Tesla will reduce the price? Or maybe you think Tesla may have a different strategy on Model Y. Let me know in the comments section below, please. Today, Elon Musk gave an update on Tesla semi-truck, saying the semi-deliveries will begin this year, ending battery constraint worries. Jovi Klender reports today from Tesla Rady saying Tesla says that deliveries of its all-electric semi-truck will begin this year. The news that Tesla delivered in its quarter 1 2021 update later seems to hint that the battery constraints issues that put the semi's initial delivery dates into question could be coming to an end once and for all. Earlier today, Tesla released its quarter 1 2021 shareholder deck and update letter that brings shareholders and enthusiasts up to date on some of the lesser known details surrounding the world's most discussed car company, Tesla. In its podcast product outlook section, the automaker revealed that the Tesla Semi is now set to begin deliveries later this year, positive news for the many pre-orders of the all-electric commercial truck. The news effectively can put an end to talks of battery constraints, an issue that has plagued automakers all who manufacture electric vehicles for years. Tesla CEO Elon Musk has said in the past that battery constraints have been the main bottleneck affecting semi production. As recently as March 2021, Elon Musk said, "Demand is no problem, but near-term cell supply makes it harder to scale semi. This limitation will be less onerous next year." Still, it is not a new issue. During the quarter three earnings call in 2020 last year, Musk said, "We need to solve the cell constraint before ramping semi to significant volume. That's the only real constraint on semi's progress." But there is news today and there is update on semi today. The semi, due to its large size, increased range, and the need for excessive power output requires a significant number of battery cells. The semi could have been produced earlier, but it could have affected the production processes of Tesla's mass market vehicle like the Model 3 and Model Y. Ultimately, the widespread consumer vehicle take priority and the semi project simply had to wait. Tesla is not dealing with any issues in terms of Tesla semi demand. However, earlier this year, it was announced that PepsiCo would be receiving 15 semi from Tesla, making it one of the first companies to accept delivery of the all-electric 18-wheeler. PepsiCo said that it expected to take delivery by the end of 2021, and Tesla's new estimates align with these predictions, especially today's new update on Tesla Semi. The hype surrounding the Tesla Semi has been especially loud this year, friends. Tesla has been building out a semi technician team in multiple locations. We have reported that at Torque News YouTube channel. The vehicle was also spotted on the Fremont test track earlier this year in a video released by Tesla on Twitter, which we also reported here if you can search and find. So along with the semi, Tesla plans to continue building out the Model Y capacity at both Giga Berlin and Giga Texas, both remaining on schedule with production and deliveries set to begin in each location in 2021. Additionally, the automaker said that Tesla's China located production plant in Shanghai is also set to continue expecting. So what do you think, friends? Are you excited that Tesla Semi is coming and delivery is starting beginning this year? Are you excited about the issue, about the question that the battery constraints and worries are ending and the truck will be coming soon? So I'm really excited about this. We have a big update from Tesla China and Gigafactory Shanghai. Reuters is reporting that Tesla will add electric vehicle components recycling facilities at Shanghai factory. Welcome news for all the people who are concerned with the environment and green lifestyle. So US electric vehicle EV maker Tesla plans to add facilities at its Shanghai factory to repair and produce key components such as electric motors and battery cells, a document submitted by Tesla to Shanghai authorities show. China, the world's biggest car market, sold over 1.3 million electric and plug-in hybrid vehicles last year in 2020, friends. China's regulators are adding rules on recycling of key electric vehicle components to save materials and protect the environment. Reuters says the document also set Tesla will add manufacturing capacities for car structures and electric motor controllers. It did not put detailed figures of its manufacturing capacities. Tesla, which is making electric Model 3 and Model Y crossover vehicles, is expanding manufacturing capacity of electric vehicle components to localize the supply chain. It also added a factory to make electric vehicle chargers in Shanghai last year. Tesla, which said on its website that materials in a Tesla car's battery are recoverable and recyclable, did not immediately respond to a request for comment from Reuters. That's what Reuters says, and adds that Tesla sold more than 35,000 locally made vehicles last month in China and is exporting to China-made cars to Europe. So I think this is a great news that Tesla is adding electric vehicle components recycling facilities at Shanghai factory. Well, friends, let me know what your thoughts are on these developments, and how do you think this is going to benefit Tesla in many ways. Of course, it's going to benefit the environment. So I'm looking forward to get more news and report this to you. Thanks for watching, dear friends. Please give us thumbs up if you found this report informative. Subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you don't miss my next news coverage. Let's continue the discussion in the comment section below. And also, please follow us on Twitter for daily Tesla and EV breaking tweets. Have a great day. God bless you, everyone, and peace be with all of you.